Operation Broken Fang has brought a huge opportunity for investors to make really solid profit, and honestly, just anybody with a battle pass to make at least their money back as well. So without further ado, let's make you guys some easy money, and of course, be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you enjoy. So let's first talk about the star system and the shop that's available for all battle pass holders. You obviously get stars by completing missions, and throughout the 16-week operation, you can earn a max of 10 stars per week. Assuming you buy none and get the max amount of stars per week, you'll be left with 160 total stars at the end of the operation. So obviously, you have a lot of different options that you can buy in the shop with these stars. One of the three skin collections, graffiti, sticker collections, and agents, and of course, the Broken Fang case. So I'm going to start with the Broken Fang case, which itself only costs 2 stars per case, meaning you could buy a total of 80 of them if you get all the stars throughout the operation. Now, the great thing about this case is that rather than it just opening right away when you buy it, like the other collections or agent packages or whatever you want to call them, you just get the case in your inventory and can list it on the Steam market, so there's no risk involved. Like, if you were to get a collection, you might get a good skin, you might get a bad skin, you'll probably get a bad skin. But currently, the cases are selling for $1 each on the Steam market because the operation just came out yesterday. So if you're solely looking to make your money back for the pass, just selling your cases ASAP before too much come into supply is a solid move. If you finish all the week's missions, you can get 5 cases and sell them for $5 right away, which is a third of the operation pass total, which isn't bad at all. And that's only 5 cases out of the 80 you'll probably get throughout the entire operation. Once again, the more time that goes on though, the more cases people are gonna list on the market and the cheaper they'll become. Even though the system is slightly different, we'll most likely see a similar price trend to the Shattered Web case, maybe a bit more drastic though because much more cases will probably be in circulation, so if you want your money back ASAP, sell cases as soon as you get them, and you'll ideally want to get them in the early days, and you'll ideally want to get them when the new week's missions start up right away before 2 people start finishing the mission so they don't tank in price again and you're making all the money you can. So that's pretty much simple enough, just buy some cases and as soon as you get them, sell them right on the market, an easy way to make your money back. But if you're actually looking to invest for long-term profit, let's look at some other price trends. Since in Shattered Web, you were forced to collect stickers, graffitis, and other stuff like that along the way, they had a pretty stable price trend on the market. That is, until a month and a half after the operation ended, where we saw a 300% price increase on the Steam market for most of the stickers in the operation. The one I'm showing here is just the Shattered Web sticker, which isn't really too sought after, it was only like 18 cents during the operation, but the price trend was similar for all the Shattered Web stickers during this time, and I'm pretty sure we'll see something similar this time around too. Especially since players can now buy stickers if they want to and aren't forced to get them. So the price increase honestly might be a little more drastic, and you can potentially use the money you get from selling cases early on to pick up some stickers during the operation, preferably the hollow and foil ones considering they look better and are more expensive and make it so you don't have to buy a ton of 20 cent stickers, just to eventually resell them if you want to hold on to them for that long later on after the operation ends, if you're really looking at maximizing out all your profits. Once again, keep in mind that cases are going to drop in price throughout the operation, so get them right away, don't hoard them throughout the entire operation, and just sell them off and let the funds sit in your wallet if you want to buy back into skins, and just wait until you see a price you like of a sticker you like it just dropped off and you want to buy into a ton of them, and sell if there's a drastic spike like last time with Operation Shattered Web about a month and a half after the operation ended. Keep in mind that everything in this operation seems to be exclusive to the operation except maybe the Control, Havoc, and Ancient collection, but considering the collections were not reused for Shattered Web, I'd assume that they won't be reused again. So this brings us into our next topic, investing in collections and agents. Let's first talk about agents. From Shattered Web, Agent Ava unfortunately just fell off in price during and after the operation, and no matter how good the agents look this operation, I unfortunately think it's going to be the same way. No one is that interested in buying agent skins, and no one wants to buy a ton of them. There's not enough demand no matter how limited or little the supply, and I think just investing in one of the other things we talked about is a much better option. But now let's talk about the collections, which have quite a bit more to talk about and can potentially make you some big money if you're patient. once again, if they aren't used in another operation, which once again, we can assume because Shattered Web did not reuse them, and this seems to be a common trend with the Battle Pass that's now going on, but who knows, it's Valve, they can always change their mind. So this is definitely a risk you have to consider. If we look at the Emerald Drawer, I'm not gonna say it, you know what I mean, you could see it on screen, I'm not gonna pronounce it, but if we look at it from the last operation, it actually hasn't had too crazy of a price uptrend yet, starting off with a pretty low price at the beginning of the operation and increasing as people started to realize how rare it was. This time around, you might just want to wait for it to stable out before investing if you are looking at investing in something from the collections, just to be a bit safer. But if we look at something like the Poseidon, which was used in the Gods and Monsters collection, which was introduced in Operation Bloodhound and used in the two preceding operations Wildfire and Hydra, and then spiked in price once Shattered Web came out and people started to realize, hey, this collection probably is never going to be used again, so the skins are super exclusive. Buying higher tier skins from this operation collection, or honestly the Shattered Web collection right now before they spike up, could be a really good move for the long term. Looking at something like an Op Prince, Op Gungnir, Emerald Deagle, not gonna pronounce it again, but just some of the higher price skins or the higher tier skins, depending on your budget, can make you a ton of money if you're really patient with it. And of course, it does give you a cool skin to use during the whole time you're holding onto it. So from what I can tell, during these operations with the Battle Pass, these collections don't seem like they're gonna be continued and seem exclusive to the operation. But once again, it is your investing, so please do it at your own risk. Valve can change their minds at any time, but if you want to put some risk in, it could definitely make you some money, and if not, I guess you've got some cool skins along the way. There is some safer options though that we obviously have gone over, being in the cases, stickers, and things like that. But besides that, that pretty much does wrap it up for this investment video, so if you guys did enjoy, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you're new. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.